BYU with John Ding and Yu Yu last night. Got first place in that thing.
Oh, yeah.
But, yeah, Kawhi Fitz Miles playing very sharp yesterday. I feel like the only issue she has sometimes is she plays a lot of online, right?
Yep.
She develops some online habits. But I think she, like, would play more offline, just, like, delete some of those.
Yep.
I think she would do even better.
I'm still waiting for the fist fight between her and Mateo that you
talked
about.
Oh, hell yeah, let's go. At E-League?
Yeah. It's going to be like when...
Is Mateo here?
I don't know. Is he?
I haven't seen him.
It's going to be like when the mega powers collide.
Damn.
Anyways, we're going to go into the action here. It's much what we expected here. Dragunov versus Alisa.
Indeed it is. Here we go. This is Pool's action, if you guys are just joining us. Very early in the tournament still, but a lot of stuff has happened. Run it black.
How come the Dragon's Nest looks like that?
Like what?
Do you see that in the background? Does it look weird?
I don't know. Oh, like the green dot?
Yeah.
Maybe that's just on our screen. I don't know.
Man, I'm seeing things. Never mind. Anyways.
Your market is tripping out.
I am definitely tripping out. You guys were talking about fruit smoothies the whole time.
Yeah, dude. Need some sustenance. Power
The follow up here. What's he going to do? I looked like that was a running two, but he kind of misinputted it there.
Yeah, definitely misinput. Jacob Prime tried the down back three. Kawhi Fitz Miles with the block.
Yeah, while standing two into the follow up there, guaranteed damage. Now Kawhi Fitz Miles up one round here against Jaycoon Prime.
Yeah,
counter hit.
You know, things are starting off here, and a lot of stuff has happened. Run it black already in loser bracket.
Incog also in loser
Incog
bracket.
Incognito loser bracket. Dimeback loser bracket, but he did make it out of his pool. He got the run back.
Yeah, against Papadon, and Papadon now out of the tournament, which is unfortunate because he played so amazingly well throughout the tournament today.
Yeah, Tasty was watching the match, said that Dimeback smoked him 2-0 in the run back. But here we go, round two, Kawhi Fitz Miles and Jaycoon. And it looks like Jaycoon's got the Reiji. Will he pull out the blue stuff? Oh, boy. Was that even
counter?
Yeah. Oh, my God. Jumping in there?
How did he get the second hit? You got hit by the second hit.
I think he panicked because he jumped. He's like, oh, my God, I better hit something. It's whipping.
Yeah, I had another chance here. And there's a punish. 1-1. Going
very
back. But Kawhi Fitz Miles is sitting very comfortable here.
Nice sidestep there on the running two.
I just saw Kayane beat Bibulous, and Bibulous looks so salty. Oh, man. I love this stuff. Man,
That's beautiful.
Tournaments. You're able to see all this action from every corner.
Kayane though, huh?
Oh, second hit, able to land here. Running two. Look at this pressure. Has Kawhi Fitz Miles
reverse.
In range now. Oh, this could be bad. This could be bad. What's he gonna do on wake up? Drive.
Same arm. Yeah,
drive.
Rage drive time.
Drive.
Woo! Do the rage drive. Oh my gosh, she's so brave.
Oh, out of the backflip.
Wait, limit?
Yep.
Oh, okay, last chance. All right, nice stuff.
That was unfortunate.
She should have pulled the trigger on the rage drive, right?
I would have, I mean, keep the advantage at least, you know? Put him into a forced block situation. 50-50.
I like that she's using the chainsaws a lot. I feel like a lot of people...
Oh, no! Don't shoot him! Oh, the float and the follow-up. We had the back one, too, there.
Yeah, he could have done it.
Nice sidestep. Man, that was
early.
That was super ballsy. Nice, okay. Down three again with the follow-up.
Take the beat. Todd with the float combo. Here comes double race. Nice side roll. 50-50. And it's the trade is in Kawhi Fitz Miles' favor, game one.
Oh, that sucks for Jaycoon because he could have definitely tied it up there, maybe potentially go to a final round, but we are now up 1-0 for Kawhi Fitz Miles. All right, looking, oh man, I forgot.
We kept talking about,
you know, all the different players out here. You better go to stage select right away. What are you looking back for? You know the rules.
No, that's what she was trying to tell
yeah.
him. He messed up. He's like, man, you got to do stage select. He's like, oh, I didn't know.
Wait, it's not even tournament mode.
It's okay.
It's fine. It helps us.
As long as Jimmy J doesn't complain about it, we'll be okay.
We'll be fine. Anyways, I forgot, aside from having the Japanese Korean players here, we have a bunch of the Europeans here as well. So Kanan Trench from Great Britain, from the good old UK, representing District G. He is in the winner's final, and he's going to fight against Commando, who we saw earlier.
Yes, the Austin
out of Pool B1. So we're going to see that hopefully coming up pretty soon.
Yeah, Kanan Trench, this is his first time at a U.S. tournament.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he was here for the
I feel like he's
global
been
finals in San Francisco.
He's never gone to EVO?
He's never been to a U.S. tournament, he said.
Oh, wow. This is big then.
Yeah,
we'll see how he does
time,
here.
First time meeting all of the scene, hanging out with the players, etc. So he's having a good time so far.
So it's going to be the first time that he gets his shit pushed in by American players. Let's go. By his commentary.
I don't know. He's pretty darn good, man.
He's
pretty darn
good. You know, Kanan Trench is an amazing player. I first saw him play at the World Tournament a few years ago when I think we were still using the vanilla version of Tekken 7.
Dude, honestly, like, I don't want to say it. I think EU and USA might be pretty darn close in skill level nowadays.
I honestly think that they may be better. Personally.
Look, okay, look. Between me and you, we can say it, but let's not admit this to anyone else.
Okay.
Okay.
Wait, the stream is here.
The stream is fine. Not like, you know, and the Europeans were here.
Oh, we can't. No, we could stroke their ego enough that they get super, super hyped, and then they die.
And then they die?
Yep, they die.
From hypo
they're going to lose. Well, an American's not even going to beat them. It's going to be like popping down from Canada or something.
Oh, God.
Let's go Canada. Well, I hope Running Black runs into those guys and they start beef. That'd be fun. I love it. Anytime Running Black has beef with a different region, like when he was beefing with Atlanta, it was amazing.
That's when he's useful.
Yeah. When he's useful. Yeah. There's a follow-up, man. Two straight rounds here. So Jaekoon Prime was able to squeeze out some rounds here, but not recently.
Running 3-4. Here's a down two. Yeah, Jaekoon Prime. I mean, it looks like, honestly, Kawhi Face Miles is very prepared for the Dragunov matchup.
Oh, yeah.
This time gets caught ducking, though. Down 4-4. Jaekoon, maybe a little unfamiliar with the Lisa matchup. Now, earlier, I was trying to say, I think a lot of players are not familiar with the Lisa Chainsaw mix-up.
Oh, yeah.
So I really liked...
And I feel like that's a thing that people should do more often, is kind of test what they know, right?
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh, so close.
Yikes.
Is she going to make a comeback?
Yo!
Oh, she's definitely going to... That was in the air.
Loaded. Yeah, it's definitely like an up 4-4 or something. Oh my God, the wall!
Can she convert? No!
Wow, it doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. Give me your shoelaces. Tie shoes together. He fell over. Game two. Kawhi Face Miles with the W. Ew.
Damn.
And the heart.
Clip it and don't send it to me.
Yeah, L-U-I-G heart, boys. That was definitely L-U-I-G heart.
Was that yours? Really? Do you have an emote like that?
L-U-I-G heart.
Oh, okay.
It's like this, but then it's like turned sideways or something.
So what is it then? It's not a heart. Was it an arrow?
It's a heart that fell over.
Oh. That's not good.
No, it's solid. It's solid.
It's solid.
It's not. I was going to say it's not cracked in the middle, but it kind of, I don't know. It's a heart.
Real quick shout out, of course, to GLHF Bar, Game Bar over in Jacksonville, Florida. You guys, many people know that there was that recent tragedy that happened over there, but we want to give a lot of love and support to everyone that's out there and the community that was affected. So if you guys have a chance, if you haven't read up on it yet, go ahead and do so. I think it's always important to just, you know, kind of have that kind of awareness, especially when you're going to gaming events. And gaming events, to me especially, it's super important. It's been a big part of my life, especially the past few years.
Yeah, I feel like everyone here at this venue, right, too. And probably most of you guys watching at home as well.